Welcome back, everyone. Now that you've identified your keywords and generated search terms, you're ready to use the library databases. We're going to use OneSearch, which is a tool that searches most of the USA Library's collections. Let's start on the South Alabama homepage. Click on Libraries at the top of the page, and then select Marks Library. That's the main library on campus, the one you'll probably use the most while you're a student. Once you're on the Marks Library homepage, you'll see the OneSearch box in the middle. It looks a little bit like a Google box, but don't be fooled. Remember, you can't talk to it the same way you talk to Google. To avoid this temptation, click on the blue link that says Advanced Search. This is going to open up a new page that gives you three search boxes. And you can use the plus sign button to add more if you need them. The reason you want multiple search boxes is so that you can use one of them for each of your main ideas. I'm going to return to the chart I created in the previous video, where I came up with search terms to help me find research on the treatment of killer whales at SeaWorld. And I'm going to use one box for each of my main ideas, starting with the first column. So I'll put killer whale in the first box, treatment in the second, and SeaWorld in the third. Then I press enter to run my search. I get 130 results, but then I remember that my professor wants scholarly peer-reviewed journals. A peer-reviewed journal is one that's been reviewed by a panel of experts in that subject, so we know the information is reliable. OneSearch makes it easy to find only peer-reviewed articles by clicking on the limiter on the left-hand side. When I do this, it gets rid of everything except one result. And this seems to be about some kind of fungal infection in dolphins. This isn't what I need for my paper about the treatment of killer whales at SeaWorld. At this point, some people get frustrated. But remember, it's normal not to find what you need on your first search. That's why you created a word bank, so you can revise your search until you find what you need. I'm going to return to my search and think about my words. If a peer-reviewed article is written by experts, I should think about what kinds of words they would use. Instead of killer whale, they would probably use the more scientific word orca. So I'm going to make that change to my search. But I get the same result. So I'm going to make more changes. Notice I only trade out related terms, words that are on the same row. I'm going to change treatment to animal welfare to be more specific and run my search again. I still get only one result, but let's look at it closely. It's specifically about the behavior and aggression of orcas kept at SeaWorld. This is perfect for my paper. If you don't find what you need, or if you need to find more articles, you can keep changing out related terms. For instance, I might change SeaWorld to the more general captivity, and I get more results. You can do this until you find what you need. Another option is to use Boolean operators, and, or, and not. You're already using one of them. See the word and in the drop-down box? That's a limiter, meaning it brings back only articles that include the words orca and animal welfare and captivity. If it doesn't include all three, then it won't show up in the results. The next Boolean operator is or. It's an expander that lets you run multiple searches at once. You should only use or to connect related terms, words that are on the same row. For example, I could search for orca or dolphin. This gives me more results because I'm doing two searches. I'm searching for orca and animal welfare and captivity, but I'm also searching for dolphin and animal welfare and captivity. Or lets you get more results, but make sure to use it only for related ideas. The last Boolean operator is not. This is another limiter since it gets rid of search terms that you don't want to see. Let's say you're interested in the dolphin family, since killer whales are part of it, but you don't want articles about bottlenose dolphins. You can add another box and use not to get rid of the search term bottlenose. If this search term is mentioned anywhere, the article will not show up, even if it's a really good article with information about your topic. So be careful when using not. You could accidentally get rid of something you need. Once you're seeing results that you need, there's one more limiter. For many topics, you only want the most recent information. And sometimes your professor will tell you that you can't have articles published more than 5 or 10 years ago. You can limit only to articles published in a certain time frame by using the publication date limiter on the left-hand side. It's 2018, so I'm going to get rid of any articles published more than 10 years ago by moving the left slider to 2008. Now I know that all of my results were published in the last 10 years. Finally, what do you do when you're finished searching? You found your search terms, used Boolean operators, limited to peer-reviewed journals, and gotten rid of anything published too early. How do you save your hard work? Look in the top right-hand corner, where you'll see a button that says Share. On this menu, look for Use Permalink. Copy and paste this link in an email, and you can go right back to your search. You'll also need this permalink to complete the final assignment, so make sure to remember where it's located. Now you are all set to start doing research. Remember, if you have questions or need help, you can always contact the friendly librarians at the Marks Library.